Good morning. We will start with the second session on fundamental unit of life. Let us recapitulate. In our previous class, we studied about fundamental unit of life, which is called as a cell, which is structural and functional unit of a living organism. We studied who discovered cell. Robert Hooke discovered cell. Then Robert Hooke actually discovered that in a dead cell, that is a bark of a tree, that is a cork. Then who discovered the first living cell in a fresh pond water? We also studied about cell theory. What exactly is cell theory? What are the points given in cell theory? Then we studied based on the number of cells, how the organisms are classified: unicellular, multicellular. We also studied what are the three main components of the cell. So which were those? So it was cell membrane, which is also called as plasma membrane. Second, nucleus and cytoplasm. We went to study the functions and properties of each of the components. In that, we covered the first one, that was cell membrane or plasma membrane, which is also known as a semi-permeable membrane, which allows in and out of the cell materials. Now, what are these materials? Gases as well as water. So, in the gases, we call them as diffusion, and water, we call it as a osmosis process. We also studied this diffusion and osmosis process, like under what type of solution it can take place. I mean to say, if a cell is put into a water, so what are the different solutions? Under what condition the cell can take in and give out the water? Under hypotonic, isotonic and hypertonic solution. In today's class, what we will do is, we will go a bit in detail about the remaining components of the cell. Okay. The first one we have covered yesterday, that is cell membrane and a plasma membrane. Let me just draw a cell. So this is the cell, this is the nucleus of the cell, the main headquarter of the cell. So it has a jelly-like structure. We all discussed this, which is called as a cytoplasm. Okay. So this outer covering, outer layer, which is known as cell membrane or a plasma membrane, right? Okay. So now, it also has another layer surrounding the plasma membrane, which is known as cell wall. What is a wall? Which covers? We have a compound in our house. Why do we have a compound in our house? So that strangers cannot get in and get out easily. Simple, right? So similarly here, we also have, we have walls of the house also, but still we have a compound for our house. Similarly, cell wall. So, cell wall gives the outer covering of a cell. Cell wall is only present in plant cell. It is absent in animal cell. There is no cell wall present in the animal cell. It is another layer. So, now what are the properties of the cell wall? So, what we can say here is, it is porous. Why it is porous? To transfer the materials in and out of the cell. Cell wall is made up of non-living. It is made up of non-living cells. It is made up of dead cells, what you can say here. This is about the cell wall. Now, what are the functions of cell wall? It gives the rigid support to the cell. First one, I will write it here. As and when we write, study the components, we will just write about that. So we are studying cell wall. So we discussed that it's present in plant, absent in animal. So about the functions, if I have to tell you, is now the first one, it gives rigid or it gives support to the cell. Second one, it gives a definite shape to the cell. Cell wall will give a definite shape to the cell. Third point I can tell here is, it is made up of cellulose. So an important question they can ask you, where do we find cell wall and what is it made up of? We find cell wall in plant cell and it is made up of cellulose. So this is about the cell wall, one part. Children, one thing you all have to know here is, in this chapter, when we study about cell or anything, the further part about cytoplasm, nucleus, cell organelles. As we go deeper and deeper, we will be studying briefly what is required in your syllabus, right? I can even exaggerate about the cell wall, give you lectures and theories on this. But in our syllabus, how much we should know about the cell wall for your grade, for 9th standard grade, how much content is required, I'll be only sticking to that and some concepts based on that. So we'll not go very much in depth about the cell wall. We'll stick to the book, how much content is given, we will go with it. So as of now, so what we understand here is, these are the functions of cell wall. Yes. Next, we'll go on to nucleus. The second most component of a cell, which is nucleus. So, nucleus is known as the headquarter of the cell. So, it is the most major component of the cell. Now, what does nucleus consist of? Nucleus consists of nucleolus. Chromatin material, we'll discuss this, and chromosomes. Okay, yeah, it consists of nucleolus, chromatin material, and chromosomes. We'll come to these, but before that, in your school, once they start with this chapter, they will allow you to see the cell in a microscope. Say for example, they take an onion peel. Once the onion peel is taken, it is kept under a microscope. You can see cell. I mean, you can see this division of room-like thing over here. Like what yesterday we discussed, a black dot, and we can see a cell. We can also locate the nucleus. But should know that only if you keep an onion peel under the microscope, the rooms might be available or the rooms might be visible, but this black dot what I have drawn, which is nucleus, is not clearly seen. So to get a clear picture, what do we use is, we use a type of a stain. What's in biology, what do we do is, we get stains. Stains are nothing, what is stains on the cloth? You have stains, right? Yeah. Similarly here, we call them as a stain. Two different stains we have. One is iodine stain and second is saffron stain. So these are colored stains. So a drop of the stain on your slide on the onion peel will help you to look at this dot like structures and the room like structure cell very clearly. Okay, this it will be done in your school. Yeah, let's come to this again. Nucleolus. What is nucleolus? Nucleolus is a part of a nucleus, what we can say. So, if you remember, in our previous class, we studied about eukaryotes and prokaryotes, right? Eukaryotes are multicellular, prokaryotes are unicellular. We discussed one point in that eukaryotes have membrane-bound, or it is nucleus has a membrane-bound nucleus, correct? It has a well-defined membrane-bound nucleus. Prokaryotes do not have a nucleus, well-defined a membrane-bound nucleus. Membrane-bound nucleus is nothing but it has an outer layer and a surrounding. One layer it has. Membrane means what? One layer, a surrounding one. Yes? So that is something called as a nucleus, a part of it. What does nucleus do? Nucleus is again porous in nature. Anything which is porous in nature allows the material in and out of nucleus. Anything which has to come into the nucleus or anything which has to go out of the nucleus. Nucleolus help. That's enough. Chromatin material. Chromatin material are thread-like structure. Yeah. They are the thread-like structures present in the nucleus. What does this consist of? It consists of DNA and protein. What is DNA? Deoxyribonucleic acid. Yes. What does it do? It carries heredity material. We'll know only so much about chromatin here. Then the next one, it has chromosomes. Chromosomes are made of chromatin material. Yes. This also comes under the DNA part only. So chromosomes are made up of chromatin material, but it is a rod-like structure. The shape of a chromatin is like a rod. Now when we talk about the shape of a, what do you say, chromatin material is like a thread. It's like a thread only. So this is about a rod-like structure. We will be studying a bit about this in the later part of the lesson. We have a structure where a cell divides. What actually happens in the cell division, we have that in the later part. We will see that. So chromosomes are made up of chromatin material, which is a rod-like structure. Now what is the main role of chromosomes? The main role of chromosomes is to inherit the traits from parents to offspring. Now, two difficult words, right? Inheritance of trait. Trait is nothing but characteristics from parents to offspring, young ones. This is something called as heredity. You have a detailed chapter of heredity in your class 10. So we study about this inheritance of characters. Inheritance of characters, let me give you an example. The characters. For example, now your father is tall. So you're tall. In example, you have a dark color skin. Depends, right? So your mother has a dark color skin. Example, color of your skin, color of your eyes, then color of your hair, you're tall, you're short. All these are inheritance of characters. We have a separate lesson in class 10 about heredity. Excuse me. So chromosomes contain chromatin material, which are rod-like structures, which helps in the inheritance of, instead of trait, I'll use the word characters. Inheritance of characters from parents to young ones or offspring. So this is about the nucleus. So main function of nucleus, it carries the activities in the cell. What all activities have to perform in the cell, it is taken care by nucleus. That is what we said, it is a headquarter of the cell, head of the family, as we say. So it takes care of all functional and structural activities of the cell. The last part, cytoplasm. Now we discussed in deep and brief about cytoplasm yesterday. Now, what does cyto means? Cyto means a cell. Plasm means a liquid. So that is what cytoplasm is, filled with a jelly-like structure, liquid. That is called as a cytoplasm. What does cytoplasm consist of? Cytoplasm consists of cell organelles. Before that, we will study about a few more things about cytoplasm. So, cytoplasm, what is the main role of cytoplasm? Yeah, it helps in the exchange of materials between the cell organelles. Now, same thing, what exchange of materials? Anything it can be, whatever a cell requires. The first most thing, it helps in the exchange of materials of the cell organelles. Second one, it helps in the metabolic pathway of a glycosis. Metabolic pathway in a cell means the chemical reactions which is happening in the cell to glycosis. What is glycosis? Glycosis is breakdown of glucose. Breaking down of glucose in the sense is whatever food we eat, right? It breaks down into simple molecules. It is converted to starch and to glucose. Actual breakdown of glucose is a very big process where you study it in detail again in class 10. We have a separate pathway, what we call as a breaking down of glucose, right? So here let us only understand that it helps the metabolic pathway of the glycosis. That is, it helps in some chemical reactions to occur such that the food is broken down. That is, glycosis is breaking down of the glucose. The next thing, as we discussed, it helps in the exchange of materials between cell organs. It also stores the vital chemicals such as amino acids, glucose, iron, etc. This is about the cytoplasm. Then we said that it has cell organelles. What are these cell organelles? Now, our body, performs many functions through different organs. Say as for example, brain performs a different function, liver, kidney, heart, goes on. So these are the different organs which perform specific functions in our body. Similarly, cell organelles, you can say they are the organs of the cell, organelles which will perform some vital specific function required for the cell to keep it alive, right? So which are those cell organelles? We'll jot it down. The first one we'll be studying about is endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum, which is also known as, we call this in short form ER. Endoplasmic reticulum is further divided into smooth endoplasmic reticulum, rough endoplasmic reticulum, SER and RER, because ER is a short form of endoplasmic reticulum. Second one you will study in this is Golgi apparatus. The another name for Golgi apparatus, we can call it as, instead of apparatus, complex, Golgi complex. Lysosomes, mitochondria, plastids, vacuoles. Yeah, how many we have written? We have written 6 cell organelles. But put together, say about in our body, we have around 10 cell organelles. But in your syllabus, we will be studying only about this 6 cell organelles. What do these cell organelles do? These cell organelles have some specific function. Each cell organelles has some specific function or a specific role to play to keep the cell alive. Each cell organelles also have a plasma membrane with them. What's the role there? It helps in the exchange of material between the cytoplasm and the cell organelles. Yes. So about the all 6 cell organelles, we'll be doing it in our next class. Yes. So in today's class, we studied about the 3 components of the cell and we studied about its properties and functions of the components. We jotted down the 6 cell organelles present in a cell. About the functions and how actually it works, we will see that in the next class. So in today's class, if you have any doubts, please call on the same day of the video set. Thank you.